Hello friends, today I am going to show you CSIR UGC NET JRF December 2017 physics question paper. Your next exam is going to be held on 15th February. If you solve the question paper from previous year, 4-5 years, then definitely you will get the benefit. So here I am going to solve part B of physics 2017 December paper, question paper. Okay, so let's start guys. So first question number 21, consider the differential equation dy by dt plus ay equal to e raised to power minus bt with the initial condition y0 equal to 0. Then the Laplace transformation ys of the solution yt is. तो इसका Laplace transform पूछा हुआ है, तो just apply the formula for derivative sys minus y0 for this and for this it is ays equal to, it is exponential and you know the formula, तो 1 upon sb. तो y0 put initial condition y0 equal to 0, then this and this term survive and take the ys comma, then you will get an answer. This is your correct answer, option A. 22 here, consider the matrix equation. Here the condition for existence of a non-trivial solution and the corresponding normalized solution is, for non-trivial solution your determinant will be 0. So determinant A is equal to 0. From that you will get the value of relation between B and C. You will get B equal to C plus 1 from there. And to solving this, just make the equations. From here you can make two equations, X plus Y plus Z is equal to 0 and X plus 2Y plus 3Z equal to 0. After solving this, you will get the value of X, Y, Z and your option number 4 is correct. And question number 23, consider the real function fx is equal to 1 divided by x square plus 4, the Taylor expansion of fx about x is equal to 0. So first solve it for the complex form. So in complex form, 1 upon z square plus 4 singular point is equal to plus minus 2y. So radius of convergence of the Taylor series of fz about z is equal to 0 here is equal to 2. The corresponding region of convergence is less than 2 in the case of fz. Similarly for fx, it will be your x mod of x less than 2. So this option number 3rd in region minus 2 less than x less than 2. The question number 24, 3 cross 3 matrix, the columns of which are denoted by the vectors a, b, c respectively. Similarly, u, v and w denote the vectors that are from the corresponding column of A transpose inverse. Which of the following is true? So for this, just solve it. Just take it inside A minus transpose. Okay. So A inverse, you know it. So 1 by determinant A, cofactors of matrix ka transpose yahan par aayega. After that, transpose overall. Okay. It will remain cofactor matrix. So cofactor matrix kya ho jayega? In cofactor matrix, your column is equal to B cross C here and C cross C here and A cross B form. And your determinant for this ABC is equal to A dot B cross C. For particular, your column is equal to U, V and W. So U is equal to your B cross C divided by A dot B cross C. Particular option number 3 is satisfying. Taking dot with A, it will be give 1, cancel out to each other. Taking B, so B dot B cross C, it will be 0. U dot C is also 0. So U dot B equal to 0 and U dot C equal to 0. Next 25, the number of linearly independent power series solution around X is equal to 0 of the second order differential equation. This is, second order differential equation is given here. So just multiply by x on both sides. So x square, so it will form a Bessel form. X square like this. X square d2y by dx square plus x dy by dx plus x square y equal to 0. This form. Here n is equal to 0. X square minus 0 into y. So n is equal to 0. So your solution of particular this form is yx equal to a jnx plus b ynx, where jn and yn is the first and second kind of Bessel functions power series solution. So yahan par n is equal to 0, so n is equal to j0 and y0 only exist, so only one solution you will get, the one power series solution you will get here. A disk of mass m is free to rotate in a plane parallel to xy plane with an angular velocity minus omega z cap about a massless rigid rod suspended from the roof of a stationary car. The rod is free to orient itself along any direction. The car accelerates in the positive x direction with an acceleration a greater than 0. Which of the following statement is true for the coordinates of the center of mass of the disk in the reference frame of the car? So already weight of the disk acting in downward direction and you are applying acceleration in one direction. So your all coordinate will be changed. All the three coordinates. Question number 27. A cyclist weighing a total of 80 kg with the bicycle pedals at a speed of 10 meters per second. She stops pedaling at an instant which is taken to be t equal to 0. Due to the velocity dependent frictional force, her velocity is found to vary as vt equal to 10 divided by 1 plus t by 30 meter per second, where t is measured in seconds. When the velocity drops to 8 meter per second, she starts paddling again to maintain a constant speed. The energy expended by her in 1 minute at this speed is acceleration from this velocity formula, the dv by dt. We will get this to find the value of 1 plus t by 30. Again, start paddling at 8 meter per second. So take the velocity here. This particular term, 1 plus t by 30 equal 8 by 10. Put it here, 0.8 square divided by 3. Now, power is equal to work divided by time, or force into distance divided by time, or force into velocity. Force equal to mass into acceleration, 80 into this acceleration. So minus 0.64 divided by 3 into your velocity. So after solving it, you will get minus 136.5 joule per second. For 1 minute, just multiply by 60 and you will get the answer 8 kilojoule. Question number 28. A light signal travels from a point A to point B, both within a glass slab that is moving with uniform velocity, with speed 0.3c. With respect to an external observer, if the refractive index of the slab is 1.5, then the observer will measure the speed of the signal h. So speed of light in that slab, first find out in that slab. So u prime is equal to c by n. So n is equal to given here, your refractive index of the slab is equal to 1.5, so put it there, okay. And your velocity v, this velocity of your moving slab at particular 0.3 c speed, so put it here and this, and at this particular u prime here, you will get the value u. And answer is 0.81c. Next question 29. A monoatomic gas of volume V is in equilibrium in a uniform vertical cylinder, the lower end of which is closed by a rigid wall and the other by a frictionless piston. The piston is pressed lightly and released. Assume that the gas is a poor conductor of heat and the cylinder and piston are perfectly insulating. If the cross-sectional area of the cylinder is A, the angular frequency of small oscillation of the piston about the point of equilibrium is mass of the piston multiplied by g is equal to pressure into area. It is your force. Force is equal to pressure into area. From here you just find out the value of pressure, this, and it is in adiabatic because it is insulating, perfectly insulating. Cylinder and piston are perfectly insulating. That means there is no exchange of heat from outside. It is an adiabatic process. So P V raised to power gamma is equal to constant. Taking derivative, you will get your dp equal to, comes out to gamma p dv divided by v. dv, it is a area multiplied by a small change in the position of piston, so a into x. So restoring force equal to dp into a. So just put it here and you will find out the value of this. So restoring force also equal to kx. So your k equal to gamma mg a divided by v. So angular frequency equal to square root k by m. Put the adiabatic constant gamma is equal to 5 by 3 for monatomic gas and you will get the answer. So square root 5 ga divided by 3 v. Next question is 30. The normalized wave function of a particle in 3 dimensions is given by psi r theta phi equal to 1 by square root 8 pi a cube e raised to power minus r by 2 a, where a greater than 0 is a constant. The ratio of the most probable distance from the origin to the mean distance from the origin is, mean distance kitna ho jayega, just find the expectation value, 0 to infinity psi star r psi 4 pi r square dr. After calculating you will get it comes out to be 3a. Okay, for most probable distance, just radial probability density, radial probability density pr is equal to r nl radial part square into r square. Okay, for the most probable radial distance r mp, your dp by dr is equal to 0. Solving this you will get your RMP is equal to 2A. Take the ratio RMP by R, it will comes out to be 2 by 3. So your answer is equal to this. Okay. Question number 31. The state vector of a one-dimensional simple harmonic oscillator of angular frequency omega at time t equal to 0 is given by ket psi 0 equal to 1 by square root 2 ket 0 plus ket 2. where ket 0 and ket 2 are the normalized ground state and the second excited state respectively. The minimum time t after which the state vector psi t is orthogonal to psi 0. So time t pe hai, after time t, to after time t aapka wave function comes to be your original into e raised to power minus e t by h ket. For particular 0 state, it will here e 0, and for excited state 2 state, it is here e 2. Okay. So just find out the value of e 0 and e 2 with this formula. E n is equal to n plus half h ket omega. For ground state e 0, n is equal to 0. So half h ket omega, e 2 is equal to n is equal to 2. So 5 by 2 h ket omega. Okay. Put it there. So you will find out the psi t value. For orthogonal condition, just put it here, psi t psi 0 is equal to 0. After solving, you will get the value of t. For minimum time, just put n is equal to 0 here, so it will be your, comes out to be pi by 2 omega. So your answer 1 is correct. Question number next. The normalized wave function in the momentum space of a particle in one dimension is phi p, alpha divided by p square plus beta square, where alpha and beta are real constant. The uncertainty delta x in measuring its position is, just take the dimension of p and beta. So p square plus beta square, that means your beta is also the same as the dimension of p. So in uncertainty principle, delta x into delta p is the order of h cut by 2. So delta x is equal to is the order of h cut divided by p. So your p and beta has the same dimension. So that implies that only option number 3rd is correct, because in other cases, option 1, 2 and 4, it is not the dimension of p. Question number 33. Let x denote the position operator and p the canonically conjugate momentum operator of a particle, the commutator 1 by 2 m p square plus beta x square plus comma 1 by m p square plus gamma x square, where beta and gamma are constant, is 0 if, just take it, so just expand it, equal to 0. This term will give you 0 value, and interchange it position, so it will minus come out to outside, and this again will give you 0. By solving this, you will get beta by m minus gamma by 2m is equal to 0. That implies gamma is equal to 2 beta is the correct answer. Question number 34. 2 point charges plus 3q minus q are placed at 00d and 002d respectively above an infinite grounded conducting sheet kept in the xy plane. At a point 00z, where z is greater than d, the electrostatic potential of this charge configuration would approximately be. Take the help of method of image and try to solve it. Okay, this is your conducting infinite grounded conducting sheet, and this is the images of this charges in opposite direction to this. Okay, with the help of this, just try to solve it. Okay, so this is particular 1.45 epsilon naught for this one minus q divided by z minus 2d, because the distance from here to here it is 2d, and from here to here it is z, to z minus 2d, n plus 3q, it is z minus t, complete distance z, and this is minus t. Okay, from here to here z minus t. Similarly for this, z plus d and z plus 2d. So solve it, to take the q outside, and z comma 1 minus 2d by z h to power minus 1. Okay, similarly to here also, since 2d by z is a very small value, as given z is greater than d, it is a small value. Do the expansion only first order, so you will get it 1 by 1 plus 2d by z, here 1 plus d by z, 1 minus d by z, and 1 minus 2d by z. After solving this term, you will get the 2d by z term only here. To multiply in this term, to q by 4 pi epsilon naught 2d by z square. So your option 2 is correct. So question number 35. A rectangular piece of dielectric material is inserted partially into the air gap between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor. The dielectric piece will be, so dielectric piece will execute an oscillatory motion in the region between the plates. Question number 36. An electromagnetic wave is traveling in free space of permittivity epsilon naught with electric field equal to k cap e naught cos qx minus ct. The average power per unit area crossing planes parallel to 4x plus 3y is equal to 0 will be. So just solve it, and you will get, so your e is given here, so b equal to जस्ट डिवाइड बाय सी एंड टेक द डायरेक्शन. तो एक्स कैप इंटू के कैप इक्वल टू माइनस जेड कैप. तो ओके डायरेक्शन. अदरवाइज यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज द फार्मूला, राइट हैंड फार्मूला, राइट हैंड रूल. ओके, योर थंब इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपेगेशन ऑफ द वेव एंड योर फिंगर्स इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, देन द कर्ल ओके इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ योर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. तो यू विल गेट माइनस जे डायरेक्शन. ओके, माइनस वाई डायरेक्शन हियर. एंड फॉर पर्टिकुलर 4x प्लस 3y इक्वल टू 0 यू विल फाइंड आउट n कैप. तो टेक द यूनिट वेक्टर. ओके, तो 4 बाई 5 एक्स कैप प्लस 3 बाई 5 वाई कैप. तो पॉइंटिंग वेक्टर, फाइंड आउट द पॉइंटिंग वेक्टर दिस एंड एवरेज पावर पर यूनिट एरिया p इक्वल टू पॉइंटिंग वेक्टर डॉट n कैप. आफ्टर सॉल्विंग यू विल गेट द 2 बाई 5 एप्सिलॉन नॉट c e नॉट स्क्वायर. नो ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट. दिस क्वेश्चन वाज रिमूव. क्वेश्चन नंबर 37. अ प्लेन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव फ्रॉम within a dielectric medium with epsilon is equal to 4 epsilon naught and mu is equal to mu naught is incident on its boundary with air at z is equal to 0. The magnetic field in the medium is H is equal to j cap H naught cos omega t minus kx minus k square root 3z, where omega and k are the positive constant. The angles of reflection and refraction are respectively. Propagation vectors kx component, matlab component in x direction is equal to k here. In z direction, kz is equal to square root 3k. So tan theta I incident angle. So tan of incident angle is equal to kx by kz. From here you get theta I incident angle is equal to 30 degree. So 30 degree incident angle for reflection. So incident angle equal to reflection. So reflection angle will be 30 degree. Now to find out the refraction, angle of refraction, use Snell's law. N1 sin theta 1 is equal to N2 sin theta 2. To find first the N1 value, for that you need C by V. So just calculate V. Given epsilon is equal to 4 epsilon naught, mu is equal to mu naught. So put it here. So V is equal to 1 upon square root mu epsilon 4 mu naught epsilon naught. Value of 1 upon square root mu naught epsilon naught is equal to C. So it will give you C by 2. Okay. Then refractive index N1 is equal to C by V. Put V is equal to C by 2. Then we will find out the value of N1 is equal to 2. Use Snell's law. N1 sin theta 1 equal to N2 sin theta 2. 2 into sin 30. Incident angle is equal to 30 degree is equal to 1 into sin theta 2, because n2 is equal to 1. From here you will get the theta 2 is equal to 90 degree. Option 2 is correct. 38. The dispersion relation of a gas of spin half fermions in two dimensions is E equal to h cut v k, where E is energy, k is wave vector, and v is a constant with the dimension of velocity. If the Fermi energy at zero temperature is EF, the number of particles per unit area is. First calculate the density of a state. From there you will find out the number of particles per unit area and you will get the answer this. Option number 4 is correct. Question number 39. The relation between the internal energy U, entropy S, temperature, pressure, volume, chemical potential and number of particles N of a thermodynamic system is du is equal to Tds minus Pdv plus mu dN, that U is an exact differential, implies that from this particular formula du is equal to Tds minus Pdv plus mu dN, P is equal to minus del u by del v at constant s, constant n. Okay, and t equal to del u by del s at constant v, at constant n. Okay, so these two are the relations. Since u is an exact differential, this relation satisfy. Okay, put the du del u by del v equal to minus p this, and del u by del s equal to t. So option number 1 is correct. Question number 40. The number of microstates of a gas of n particles in a volume V and of internal energy U is given by. Number of microstates is given here. A and B are positive constant. Its pressure P, volume V, temperature T are related by. We have to find out the relation. So first find out the entropy from this relation. So entropy is equal to KB ln omega. Omega is given here. Put it in this particular equation. Take the log of this N ln V minus NV plus your this term. From this same relation, this implies Tds is equal to du plus Pdv minus mu dN. Okay. From this equation, you can find out P. P is equal to T del S over del V at constant U at constant N. Put the value of S from here. Take the derivative with respect to V and you will find out the value. So P equal to KB TN 1 upon V minus NB. Option number 4 is correct. Question number 41. Consider a system of identical atoms in equilibrium with black body radiation in a cavity at temperature T. The equilibrium probabilities for which the equilibrium probabilities for each atom being in the ground state ket 0 and excited state ket 1 are P0 and P1 respectively. Let N be the average number of photons in a mode in the cavity that causes transition between the two states. Let omega W0 W1 and W120 denote respectively the squares of the matrix element corresponding to the atomic transition 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Which of the following equation hold in equilibrium? So option number 4 is correct here. Okay, this is showing the absorption. Stimulated absorption depends on your square of the matrix element and your photon and number of atoms. Spontaneous emission term, and this is your stimulated emission. So option number 4 is correct. Question number 42. In the circuit below, the voltage VBB and VCC are kept fixed. The voltage measured at B is a constant, but that measured at A fluctuates between a few microvolt to a few millivolt. From these measurements, it may be inferred that. So four option is there. Base is open internally. If base is open internally, then it is not possible, incorrect. Emitters is open internally, then it will be open circuit, not possible. Collector resistor is open, if no finite value here, base resistor is open. In that condition, you will get this constant value, okay? Option number 4 is correct. Now question number 43. The full scale voltage of an N-bit digital to analog converter is V. The resolution that can be achieved in it is. It is a direct formula, V upon 2 raised to power N minus 1. Correct answer. The spring constant K of a spring of mass MS is determined experimentally by loading the spring with mass M and recording the time period T for a single oscillation. If the experiment is carried out for different masses, then the graph that correctly represents the result is. So when mass of a spring is MS and a block of mass M is attached with it, then the equivalent mass of the system equal to MS divided by 3 plus M. Put it in the formula of period of oscillation T equal to 2 pi mass by K. So mass is equal to ms by 3 plus m divided by K. Take the square. So T square is equal to 4 pi square ms by 3 plus m divided by K. Now go to the option. So when m is increasing, T is increasing. So option number 3rd is wrong. When m is equal to 0, in that condition there is ms also there. So it is T square is non-zero value. So this option 2 is incorrect and this is also incorrect. So option 1 is correct only. Question number 45. A zener diode with an operating voltage of 10 volt at 25 degrees Celsius has a positive temperature coefficient of 0.07% per degree Celsius of the operating voltage. The operating voltage of this zener diode at 125 degrees Celsius is. So increment in zener voltage delta Vz, formula Vz into temperature coefficient into change in temperature. So just put it, 10 volt is given here, 10 volt into 0.07%, so 0.07 divided by 100 into temperature difference 125 degrees Celsius minus 25. You will find the value 0.7. Vz final equal to Vz plus delta Vz. So it will be 10.7. Option number 3rd is correct. Okay guys, this was the part B, and in next I will put video containing part C. Depends on your interest. Guys, please like and subscribe. Till now I have only 32 subscribers, but aim rakhte hain 40 subscriber ho jayen. When it is 40 subscriber, then only I will put the C part. Okay guys, good luck for your exams. Thank you. Bye.